Hello, and a very warm welcome to LNT Royal YouTube channel.
Prince Harry walked away from his senior royal role last month, and now the Duke had also ditched his royal surname. The details came to light after Harry registered his new eco-friendly tourism firm Travelist. In the registration documents, Harry appears to have ditched both his HRH title and the royal family name Mountbatten, Windsor, and is instead listed as Prince Henry Charles Albert David, Duke of Sussex. Back in February, Prince Harry spoke at a travel summit in Edinburgh and asked delegates to just call him Harry. Before he took to the stage, the prince told host Aisha Hazarika she should introduce him as just Harry. "He's made it clear that we are all just to call him Harry. So ladies and gentlemen, please give a big, warm Scottish welcome to Harry," she told the room at the Travelist event. The Duke and Duchess of Sussex stepped down as senior royals on March 31st, and have been living in Canada and the US ever since. And while the couple had hoped to make a clean break and become financially independent, royal commentator Angela Mollard says that Harry may already be feeling very isolated and beginning to regret his decision to cut ties with the royals. Angela said on New Ideas Royals podcast, "I really worry about Prince Harry. He is someone who is very connected to his family, as it is all he has ever known. He had his life with his mom Princess Diana and his dad Prince Charles, and then he had his life with them separately when they divorced." Another analysis: why Meghan Markle and Prince Harry aren't in a rush to have baby too? Soon after Prince Harry and Meghan, Duchess of Sussex, married in a lavish ceremony in Windsor, England, it was announced that they were expecting their first child. Fans, as well as members of the royal family, were beyond thrilled to welcome the newest royal, and they were also extremely happy that Meghan and Prince Harry were about to become first-time parents. Suddenly, the excitement was at an all-time high, with people speculating as to whether Meghan would give birth to a boy or a girl, what the possible choices for names were, and whether or not the child would have a royal title. It wasn't long before the Duchess was nearing the end of her pregnancy, and everyone was anxious to hear whether or not the baby had finally been born. It was on May 6, 2019, that Archie Harrison arrived in the early morning hours, and soon after, Prince Harry went on camera for the first time as a new father. When both parents introduced their son to the world a short time later, they were beaming with pride, leading fans to think that a second child wouldn't be far behind. However, this isn't necessarily the case, so let's talk about why Meghan and Prince Harry aren't in a rush to have baby number two. The arrival of baby number one. Less than 6 months after they officially became husband and wife, Harper's Bazaar reports that Meghan was pregnant with the couple's first child. The announcement was made via social media, with the Duke and Duchess thanking everyone for their love and support. Throughout the pregnancy, Meghan and Prince Harry remained pretty secretive regarding the details. No one was sure whether the mother, too, would give birth at home or in a traditional hospital setting, and rumors were flying over whether they would use a nanny, and even whether or not Meghan would reconcile with her estranged family members so that they could have a relationship with her new child. Meghan looked wonderful the entire time that she was carrying the royal baby. When the news broke that she had given birth, the couple instantly began receiving congratulations from all around the world. Prince Harry has always known that he wanted children. Even before meeting Meghan, Prince Harry knew that he wanted to be a dad. He was already an uncle to Kate, Duchess of Cambridge, and Prince William's kids, but that didn't stop him from longing for little ones of his own. Almost like a big, playful kid himself, it was evident that Prince Harry would make a great father. He expressed his desire to do so on more than one occasion. Back in 2012, he told an interviewer that he was looking forward to having children someday, and said the same thing again in 2015. A year later, Prince Harry said in another interview that he couldn't wait for the time to come when he would have a family of his own, and luckily, in 2019, his dreams came true. Why Meghan Markle and Prince Harry aren't in a rush to have baby number two? It is clear from their actions and statements that Archie is the main focus in their lives, so will Meghan and Prince Harry soon announce that they are expecting a second baby. chances are, that won't happen for a while. According to US Weekly, the couple isn't in any rush. Why not? Well, since they just made a major life change by moving to Los Angeles, they want some time to get settled and let Archie get used to his new surroundings. Right now, their main focus is giving their son all of the attention that they can, and they know that another baby will come in due time. An insider told US Weekly, "They're still enjoying these precious early days with him, they're committed to having another baby, but don't want to put too much pressure on the situation." In other news, Prince Harry and Meghan Markle warned by Los Angeles paparazzi. They'll be hounded every single day. News of Prince Harry and Meghan Markle's departure from royal life immediately sent royal watchers into a tizzy. In March, the couple officially backed away and settled into a home in Vancouver Island, Canada temporarily before packing up and moving to California. On the one hand, the relocation wasn't that surprising given that Meghan is a Los Angeles native. On the other, Harry's made it clear that he craves more privacy and less intrusion from the press. What do local paparazzi think about their presence in this celebrity enclave? It will be a frenzy. Harry and Meghan are on lockdown. Like most of the country, the couple and their baby Archie are in quarantine due to COVID-19. Isolated in a Los Angeles area, supposedly Malibu mansion in a gated community, it's expected they'll put down roots in the region. According to reports, they want to live in a secluded, secured home. With the lockdown restrictions in place, it's been hard for paparazzi to trail Meghan and Harry. But that doesn't mean the photogs aren't primed to pounce on them once they venture out. Photographer says photos could fetch six figures. Now that Harry and Meghan are in a Hollywood hub, it will be tricky for them to avoid the spotlight. Per The Times UK, California paparazzo Mark Karloff said groups of photographers are already camping out trying to catch a glimpse of the couple. He also stated that once the quarantine rules are relaxed and the public is more aware of Harry and Meghan, it's going to be a little bit of a frenzy to get to them. Per Karloff added, "They are going to be hounded every single day, at least for the first few months," he said. "They're not going to be able to go out without being photographed." He provided a ballpark estimate of how much those first exclusive photos could sell for, saying the amount may go as high as $100,000. Since they are considered A-listers, catching images of them in their new digs will likely be a huge payday for paparazzi. Karloff continued, "Leo DiCaprio, global interest, Beyoncé, global interest. That's what Meghan wants. I hope she's ready for it." The media attention on Harry and Meghan won't be like Canada. While fans and paparazzi sought out the royals when they were still living in Canada, the pair took legal precautions and local papers didn't print salacious stories about them. Additionally, there are Canadian laws in place that favor one's consent when it comes to having their pictures printed in a publication. Per the Vancouver Island Free Daily, judges tend to consider whether someone grants permission to have a photo shared publicly. However, when out in a public space, things can get murky. Still, with the Sussexes living in a celebrity hotspot, to some it seems counterintuitive to move to an area saturated with paparazzi. Will Harry end up filing lawsuits here too? Karloff has been in the business for more than 10 years and noted that people who work as photographers can get very hungry for certain celebrity shots. Once social distancing and quarantine measures loosen up, he knows it will be a matter of time before Harry and Meghan are a hot commodity. Please support growing LMD Royal Channel by subscribe channel, like and share videos us. Your support is the motivation for us to produce better videos. If you have any suggestions for us, please leave your comments below. Don't stop. Check out one of our newest videos right here. Plus, even more LMT Royal videos about your favorite royals are coming soon. Subscribe to our YouTube channel and hit the bell so you don't miss a single one.